Hello, ladies and gents, it's Hagbard Selene here on another beautiful afternoon and back from my brief but much-needed break. And I'm going to be answering in this short video the question that I am asked on a regular basis. Why I address these issues that are trickling down from academia if, in reality, we can all go through our daily lives and not experience this kind of stuff. This kind of rhetoric is mostly existent online and doesn't have any real-world repercussions, right? Well, I found this video randomly, scrolling along for what I actually watch when I peruse YouTube in my free time. Fight videos, and argument videos, and public freakouts. And I found this one particularly interesting, because of the language used and the information he put in his little description bar. And I'll be reading that at the very end. But know that this video is going to be probably heavily edited from the original, which contains lots of fluff time, as most confrontations do, and we will be focusing on some of the tone shifts and some of the language use, which I think is very revealing about some of the problems we're having right now. So, I hope you enjoy. Okay, so going by the description that was given by this gentleman, he didn't get the camera on in time to show that the bike was indeed pinned at some point between this person's truck and the other truck. And we can clearly see that the aggressors here are wannabe Rihanna and some guy from the Thriller video. By the way, the fact that the 80s is coming back is something I'm lamenting deeply right now.
Why are you hitting the fucking car?
What you fucking hit my car?
Why are you hitting the car?
And, foolishly believing that he can still reason with these people, he's answering their question. I hit the side of your car because you tried to hit me, repeatedly, with said car.
Get the car, babe! You almost hit me with your car twice! Yo! Twice!
This thing got a baton, son.
What we have here is felony assault. And if the races were reversed and this played out the way it's about to, potentially a hate crime. I don't even particularly care for hate crime laws, but if you think the attorney in the reverse wouldn't push for it, I'm here to tell you you're dead wrong.
This is amazing, I love it.
And as we can see here, they pursue the gentleman for a not insignificant period of time and continue to assault him.
Get him.
Yo, guys, chill. Yo, chill, chill. Yo, bro, please chill. Yo, bro, chill, chill. Miss. Miss, chill. Miss, chill, please.
I would like to note that what we just witnessed was the gentleman with the baton realizing that there were other people around witnessing this felonious assault, folding said baton, and then returning it to his vehicle. And credit where credit's due, the man with the camera on the bike here does try, in the beginning, to defuse the situation.
Miss, they're gonna call the cops. Please, miss, please, chill, bro. I don't want you in jail, please.
Shut the fuck up, nobody's gonna hit you, nigga.
Just take the L, just take the L. Miss, just take the L, just take the L. Just take the L. Don't kill nobody, please. Yo.
Mind you, at this moment, it is clear as day who the bad guys here are, who the assaulters are, who the people who are breaking the law are, who the perpetrator and who the victim in this situation is very clear right now. And it is about to pivot 180 degrees.
Just don't talk, yo, just go. Yo, dude, go, just go.
No, I'm pressing charges.
Let's go, man.
Charges on what, nigga?
I already called, they're coming.
Charges on, so what, suck a dick, how about that?
No way, you're going to jail.
Yo, bro, go, just go.
Who's going to jail? I'll touch you if I want to.
Please, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it. Don't do it, don't do it. Don't do it, yo, bro.
Yes, both of you should probably be in jail. However, you're probably not going to be.
Bro! Yo, bro, chill, man. They're gonna call the cops. Come on. Yo, bro. 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 Yo, bro. Bro. Bro, come on. Yo, they're gonna call the cops, please.
Are we gonna talk about disproportionate representation in crime statistics now, or is this an inconvenient time, I think?
Oh shit! You gotta fuck this nigga up. Yo, white boy, get the fuck out of here!
And now it's his problem. Now it pivots to race. For some reason, now this is a black area, and you should respect these angry black people and leave because you're white. White people leave. This is absurd that you would even pivot this hard and this fast and then post this video on your own channel. You scumbag.
White boy, go!
See what I mean? I hate to be this guy, but let's be honest. Reverse it, and it makes it real easy what's going on here, doesn't it? But this is fine, and it's gonna be further validated. And there's a reason why I stuck with this long, besides just this lovely little pivot point.
White guy, take the L! White guy, take the L and dip! Yo, I tried to help you, bro! I tried to help you! Leave, my nigga! Leave, bro! Just leave! Go away! Go away, my nigga! Go away! Take the L, white man! Take the L!
And now, we have joy and glee from just a random passerby of color who's enjoying this game. That's the new way to play. This is just what's okay now. And it's going to be validated further by her statements. Just wait.
Please, I'm begging you, I'm just trying to help you. I love this.
Somehow, being verbally and physically assaulted for about a block, and then asking a passerby for help is white privilege. Because you're not being complete animals right now, right?
I'm right here with that white person. Touch the car again! Touch the car!
I don't know, he's dumb. Yo, leave them alone! Just leave them alone!
Yes, white boy, leave them alone because you clearly pursued them.
You're alive! You're alive, bro! I'm trying to save everybody's life!
Yes, you're a grand hero trying to save everybody's life, in spite of the fact that you're currently defending two people who vehicularly and then verbally and physically, and one with a weapon, assaulted this man. But you know, he's white, so he probably shouldn't be in this neighborhood anyway, right?
I'm trying equality!
I crashed into a truck. They ran into a truck, bro.
I know how you feel. Bro, I know how you feel.
You stupid nigga! You don't know fuck about no police, nigga!
That might be one of the reasons why there's such an overrepresentation in jails and prisons, but far be it for me to make that.
What the fuck out of here?
In your face, nigga. Try me, nigga.
Yo, just go. Just go, please. Just take the L. Take the L. You know they're crazy. Take the L.
I'm waiting for the cops to get here, man.
This guy ran me into a trap.
I'm out. I can't help. I'm out.
So that's it. It turns out that when bullshit academia trickles down to the everyman, they'll use it to validate completely insane actions. Like acting like a complete hood rat and assaulting someone, and then proclaiming it as white privilege when he attempts to contact the authorities or have others do so on his behalf. You realize you sound like a lunatic, and you're making everyone look bad, right? Just so you know, you're not helping race relations and you're not moving the race forward by behaving this way. You look bad. You look very bad. And the description that was left on this video actually reinforces what I'm saying here. And I'll read it to you in full, and I will link it in the description so you can see this original video, uninterrupted, and read his description for yourself. His description reads, "Sorry, not sorry for the prejudiced words on my part, heat of the moment, and being where I'm from. I was at work, and working, and I had to be very fast with my delivery times in this moment, but I stopped to see if I could help this dude. I wish my camera turned on when this couple pinned this guy to the truck he ran from. I hate violence, but that's something I struggle with inside of me every day, which goes back to my childhood. I hope you can understand that I love everyone, but you cannot tell me shit when I'm an oppressed person. People can do evil to my people and just expect you to forget? Doesn't work like that for me. I've been brainwashed every day to hate myself, and it took a white girl to show me who I was. I would never say I'm black. I would just say I'm Puerto Rican and Filipino, because I thought being black was wrong, and I hated that was a part of me. It seemed like only white people had the good life in the media, and I wanted to be like them. So I did whatever I could to not mention why I was black and just come up with lame lies, not addressing my real roots. How is that associated to you sitting here and defending two people who are assaulting a random white guy? Just because he's white, and they were non-white, and you're also non-white. So you're in the right club. This has gotten out of hand. And as usual, ladies and gents, stay safe, good luck, and goodbye.